What's up guys, it's Michaela. Welcome back to my channel. So if you notice a change in the video quality, I got a new camera. I bought the Canon EOS M50 strictly for my YouTube videos. If you guys weren't aware, I was using my Canon T4i, which I am currently using for my wildlife photography as well. So about to upgrade to the Canon R6. Hopefully soon with all my Christmas and birthday money. But yes, I got a new camera. I'm so excited. So if anything seems off in this video, this is my first video I'm filming with it. So give me at least a couple videos to get used to it. But today I'm going to be talking about the humpback whale population in Southern California and Mexico. I'm very, very excited. Humpback whales are my favorite mysticeat of all time, and I'm just really excited for today's video. I'm in a really good mood, but I hope you guys enjoy, and let's dive in. Obviously, their common name is humpback whale, but their scientific name is, I need to pull it up on my phone. Don't come for me if I butcher this, but it is Megapertra novalangiae. I'm gonna put it on the screen. Here's their scientific name. Full-grown humpback whales typically get between 43 and 46 feet, and fully grown females get anywhere between 49 and 52 feet. Humpback whales live quite a long time, as a lot of whales do. So their average lifespan is between 45 and 50 years, but they have the potential to live between 80 and 90 years. So a lot of whales, if you didn't know, do have human-like lifespans. Killer whales, Grandma, I think her name was, Granny. Granny was her name, lived over 100 years, and that is insane. They can My mom's calling me. What's up? As I was saying, a lot of whales do have human-like lifespans. There is a bowhead whale that is dated to have been born over 200 years ago. So that's crazy. But yeah, humpback whales live a long time. So humpback whales are mysticeats, which means they have baleen in their mouth. Their baleen is made up of keratin, which is what our fingernails and hair are made out of. So that kind of gives you an idea of how it feels. But since they are mysticeats, that means they are also filter feeders. Obviously they can't chew their food because they don't have any teeth. So filter feeders will typically eat small crustaceans, particularly krill, and small fish. Humpback whale feeding strategies are some of the most interesting out of every whale. They participate in lunge feeding, which is so incredibly great to see. A humpback whale lunge fed around 10 feet from our boat, probably about a month ago. I have a picture of it, which I will put up on the screen. So this was not zoomed in or anything from our boat, so that just gives you a clear picture on how close it actually was, and they also participate in bubble netting. Like a lot of whale species, humpback whales are protected under the Endangered Species Act. If you guys weren't aware, back in the whaling days, a lot of whale species were whaled to the point of brink extinction. That is horrible. Luckily, not every country does it still. I think Norway might still do it. There's a few countries such as Japan and a couple others that still participate in whaling, which I do not agree with, but a lot of these whale populations have not been able to bounce back from the whaling days, such as right whales. Right whales got their name because they were the right whale to kill. They were super slow, which made them a very, very easy target for whaling. Humpbacks were whaled to the brink of extinction, which is why they are protected under the Endangered Species Act. And since they are marine mammals, they are protected under the Marine Mammal Protection Act. And I have a video coming out about that very, very soon. I'm gonna dive into all of the logistics and legal stuff about the Marine Mammal Protection Act, so keep a lookout for that very soon. Humpbacks are found all over the world. They're found in Hawaii, they're found in the Antarctic, they're found in Southern California, they're found in the Southern Hemisphere and Northern Hemisphere. They're found in every ocean, but today we are going to be talking about the California / Mexico population. So let's dive into talking about the California and Mexico population by itself. The humpback species as a whole can be found all up and down the California coast. However, humpbacks in Southern California will come to Southern California and feed in our colder waters. Colder waters are more dense in nutrients, if you did not know that, and they will migrate down to Mexico for the warmer waters and breed. Like I said in the beginning of this video, humpback whales are one of my all-time favorite whales, next to killer whales, of course. But they are one of my favorite species of whales because they are so individual to each whale. Each whale has its individual personality, individual identifying marks, individual behaviors. They are just so unique to each whale. It's crazy. They're like human beings. Like I said, each whale has identifying marks that allow us to identify them. But some whales have easier identifying marks and other whales have really, really difficult identifying marks to see. So look at Twitch, for example. Twitch is very, very easy to identify. We assume that he was entangled in some fishing gear, but luckily was able to be free from it and survived. But this makes him very, very easy to identify. And let's look at another whale, Chief. His identifying marks are a little bit harder to see. You actually have to get a very good look at his fluke. He has two little googly eyes on, I guess, the left side. If you're looking at the picture on a computer screen or a phone screen, his identifying googly marks or googly eye marks are on the left side of his fluke. So obviously you cannot identify every species of whale, such as fin whales, because they don't really have a lot of identifying marks or features on them. But since humpbacks are very individual whales, we are able to track them and research specific whales on happywhale.com. If you guys don't know what Happy Whale is, it is a citizen-ran research website. Citizen-ran means citizen, such as I, can submit photos and they'll be able to research them and track them. So it's really, really exciting if you are looking to get more involved in whale research or marine biology or just humpbacks in general interest you, I highly recommend checking out the website Happy Whale. You can look up individual whales. I'll put a screen recording up here. So in this recording, I looked up my favorite whale, Chief, and I am able to track him. So he was seen all over California, and it is really, really great if you're interested in specific whales. You can see where they're going and see where they're coming from, and it is just a really great way to get involved in some humpback whale research. A lot of people ask me on my Instagram, when is the best time to see whales in Southern California? So let's talk about that. So humpback whales typically come, like I said, to Southern California to feed on our nutrient-dense water. Over summer, we saw three particular whales pretty much all summer. I think there were very few days where we did not see them, and they were Twitch, Flicka, and Frankie. I will put pictures of all of these whales up from over the summer, but we saw them pretty much all summer. And as we're slowly moving into the fall months, this is also a really great time to see humpback whales. So we've been seeing whales such as Snowflake, Chalkboard, and Chief has recently been seen again. I first saw Chief November of 2019 on my very first whale watching trip with my company, but it was before I worked with my company. But this guy has a special place in my heart just because he was the first humpback whale that I ever saw. There is no designated humpback whale season, as they don't have a migration route like gray whales. If you guys didn't know, we see gray whales yearly from probably late December to late April, early May, and that is because they are coming from Alaska and they're swimming down the coast to Mexico to breed in Mexico's lagoons. So humpback whales don't really do that. They just kind of come when there's an abundance of food, which typically is in the summer and early fall months. I mentioned earlier in the video that Twitch has a really, really big wound on his fluke. It is healing very nicely. He was one of the very lucky whales that was able to heal and recover from an injury like that. A lot of whales do not recover from something like that. We have a lot of theories on what happened to Twitch, and unfortunately we will never know what happened because nothing was reported. However, a lot of people at my work, including me, believe that he was entangled in fishing line or fishing gear. Fishing gear is a huge, huge, huge threat to whales, along with vessel strikes and vessel harassments from whale watching vessels, recreational vessels, and other vessels such as cargo ships. So it's really important that we are cleaning up our fishing line and we are educating people who are going out on boats. So one way that we can help humpback whales is just simply educate people. People are more likely to care about something when they know about something. If someone learns about a humpback whale, they're gonna be more likely to participate in conservation for humpback whales. They're gonna be more likely to love these whales and want to protect them. So education is really, really big, and just cleaning up after yourself. If you are going out fishing, clean up your fishing line. They might not affect big whales like humpback whales, but those tiny, tiny fishing lines that you use on an everyday basis, on an everyday fishing pole, are gonna entangle a sea lion. Sea lions are really susceptible to just regular fishing line entanglements. It's really, really sad, but it's the truth, and education and conservation and beach cleanups will help with that. All right, guys, that is all the information I have for you on humpback whales in California. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys for watching. If you liked it, make sure you hit the subscribe button. We are super close to 1.5K subscribers, and there will be another giveaway when I hit 2,000 subscribers. And I'll see you guys in my next video.